Good morning, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd 2014, and I give all thanks to the Heavenly Father for allowing me another day to see another year. So, with that being said, I'm going to come at you this year directly out of the Word, like always, but I'm going to come straight and uncensored. People are not listening to, people are not studying, people are not taking heed to the Father's Word. I'm hearing the same things over and over and over. So I'm going to keep giving the same information from the Word over and over, but I'm going to come at you hard, direct, and uncensored, because it needs to be pounded into some psyches out there that this is what we need to adhere to. This is what we need to abide by so that we don't have all these worldly issues in our life. So with that, let's get straight into it. Our first topic of discussion this year is going to be gay marriage. That's right, I said it, gay marriage. I'm going to tell you about the world, and I'm going to tell you what the Father's Word says. Now, first of all, people throw the term gay marriage around as if the two were synonymous with one another. See, then the world also has the audacity to drag Scripture into it as if the Father in heaven would have anything to do with it. Now, let's be clear, in the world, this phrase or this concept may work for the desires of man, but the Father is clear in His Word that these two are mutually exclusive concepts. See, the Word doesn't address gay marriage because the Father cuts off the need for it to even be a discussion at the root. Therefore, the Word never has to address the worldly concept of homosexuality and marriage as a possibility that is acceptable in any form to the Almighty. These two are separate subjects. But first, let's discuss the marriage part, since we've made clear that they are separate subjects when it comes to the Father. Now, first of all, we need to know, what does marry mean, or to be married or marriage? To marry or to wed simply means what? To unite intimately, to combine suitably or agreeably, or to blend, or to join or acquire. That's simply what marriage is, or what to marry means. It doesn't matter what the two things are, people, objects, or whatever. Businesses marry together every day. Chemicals and products are mixed or married daily to create other products and chemicals. People marry themselves to idolatry in things, habits, objects, behaviors, continually. So this is what marry or to have a marriage or something means. It means to just simply bring together. Now, the Father's Word does not say that He is against gay marriage, nor does He say He is for it. In fact, gay marriage, like I said, is not even a scriptural issue. Gay marriage is not even addressed in Scripture, not that I've found. Now, if you find it, let me know. I'm not infallible, but I haven't found it. Now, these are two different areas of debate and conflict which have been married together by man, with Scripture dragged into it to make them an issue. And that lie cannot be farther from the truth. See, the devil has gotten everyone again caught up in deception. This is man's doing with the help of the enemy backing it. Now, go with me to Jeremiah 2:32. It continues on marriage and reads, it says, "Can a maid forget her ornaments or a bride her attire? Yet my people have forgotten me days without number." See, the Almighty says simply that when it comes to a wedding or marriage of people, that a bride or bridesmaid, whomever, they won't forget all that's involved in this festivity, but they have forgotten Him since He's freed mankind. Go with me to Psalms 106 to 11. It reads, it says, "They forgot God their Savior, which had done great things in Egypt, wondrous works in the land of Ham, and terrible things by the Red Sea." See, as then, people don't even think about Him and all He's done. people murmur, complain, Exodus 15:24, and they don't even wait for his counsel, Psalms 106:13. People just go off doing their own thing without prayer or guidance from their Father, and then they wonder why they have all these problems in their lives. So the question is, why are people so concerned about marrying anyone, same sex or otherwise, when they first aren't even married to the Father and His Word? That's what it's about. See, people are thinking of themselves and what they want. Then after the fact, so many of them have the audacity to go to the Father in passing and ask Him to bless these worldly unions that aren't even designed by Him. See, if we get involved with Him first, He will orchestrate and design the heavenly unions that we should all be involved in. But yet, like I said, we go on doing our own thing and then want Him to bless this mess. See, people just bypass marriage to the Father, which surely would eliminate all the problems we have in our worldly marriages if we married Him first. If you get into that marriage and commit to it, your problems would be solved. But if you bypass His offer of marriage and jump into straight into the world, then you get what you get. You get divorce, you get abuse, you get gay marriages, you get broken families, you get adultery, on and on and on. See, people want to be married, but they don't want to really commit to it, especially in the world. And there's no way you really can when you're not even committed or in a committed marriage to Him. See, a committed marriage to Him is a prerequisite to a successful worldly marriage, because you're always aware of to whom you have to answer to, where all your guidance comes from, where all your wisdom comes from, etc., etc. Revelation 19:19 reads, "Blessed are they which are called unto the marriage supper of the Lamb." See, He calls all of us, but only a few, as with all things, listen. Only a few people listen. Matthew 22:2-5 reads like this. Pay attention. It says, "The kingdom of heaven is like unto a certain king which made a marriage for his son, and sent forth his servants to call them that were bidden to the wedding, and they would not come. Again he sent forth other servants, saying, Tell them which are bidden, Behold, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and my fatlings are killed, and all things are ready. Come unto the marriage. But they made light of it and went their ways, one to his farm, another to his merchandise." See, the Father has prepared everything for us, and He's called us, but many are refusing to let go of the world and marry Him. They're caught up in the things of the world, and they don't want to let that go. People love their stuff so much that they are truly willing to risk their salvation. Understand, people, this is a salvation issue. And for those who don't think it's a salvation issue, listen to this. Matthew 25:5-10 reads like this. "While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept." Now, to tarry means to stay longer than intended, or a delaying leaving a place. See, the Father is delaying His departure to come get His own. See, He's tarrying, but yet people are still in a slumber and sleep. Verse 6, "And at midnight there was a cry made, Behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, Give us your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered," or those that were prepared, "they answered, saying, Not so, lest there not be enough for us and you, but go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves." Verse 10, "And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut." See, this is the marriage that the Father cares about. And if we're not ready when He comes, see, people are going to be scrambling around trying to get what they need, and those who are ready are going to say, "No. This is for me. If I give you some of what I have, then I won't be prepared." So those people are going to be lost. We have to be ready when He comes, because when He comes, He's going to get His own and leave, and then the door is going to be shut. There's going to be no way to get there from here. We have to be ready when He comes the first time. So look, people, let any and everyone have all the worldly things they want, marriages included, to whomever or whatever they want to be married to. These are just worldly marriages. sanctioned and created by man. They aren't sanctified by the Father. This is man's doing, but man is dragging the Father into it as if the Father, like I said, would have anything to do with it. He doesn't. But other than that, let's find out what the word says about the gay part of gay marriage. Stay tuned. This is Brother Lloyd. Watch your feelings and move your toes. I'm out.